Continuing on the custom card review streak, we're going to be talking about a year 8 EZA concepts, and it's coming in from Say. But before I go ahead and read Say's custom EZA concept, send me custom cards over to bhfcustomcards@gmail.com so I get to your custom card or EZA concept as soon as possible while I'm getting all these recent custom cards and EZA concepts out the way. So with that being said, guys, just like yesterday, I am on time constraints and there is no messages inside the email. So Say, thank you for sending in your custom card. All right, what do we have here? Let's see exactly what these guys are doing. So their new buffed up leader skill for Power of Wishes or Battle of Fate is from 3 key and 170% across the board to 3 key and 180% across the board. And they're getting like 70%, what? So they're a 250% leader skill because they're giving 70% of the stats to Final Trump Card and Shadow Dragon side characters. So they're a 250% leader skill. This would not happen in Dokkan. And they're 12 key. They greatly stack attack and gain 30% defense for one turn and greatly lower the enemy's attack while having a 50% chance to stun. So a very loaded 12 key. And their 18 key, they massively stack attack. And no, they don't massively stack attack. They just get 100% attack and 50% defense for one turn and disable enemy action. Okay, then. And their passive, that being Deadly Final Battle, 280% attack and defense at the start of turn, and randomly changes keys of a certain type to STR for 4 turns. Nice. They get 80% damage reduction on their first turn, and they also get 80% attack and defense when HP is 50% or more. Nice. And an additional 2 key per keys are obtained, and an additional 200% defense, and guard is the first attacker in the turn. What? And they also get 3 key per keys are obtained, 200% attack, and 30% damage reduction as the second or third attacker in the turn. Okay. And they launch 2 additional attacks. They both have a 70% chance to come a super attack when key is 18 or more. And they launch a guaranteed super, and they get guaranteed crit when key is 24, which should be easy considering the fact that their 2 key per keys are obtained inside the first slot, and their 3 key per keys are obtained inside the second or third slot. Just that should be very easy for them to get off. And they also get 1 key and 25% damage reduction up to 50%. And all allies get 2 key and 25%, excuse me, attack and defense up to 5 key and 50% attack and defense for 2 turns with each super attack performed. Okay. And they have a 70% chance to dodge and 80% attack and defense and disables dodge canceling after revival skill is activated. Holy hell. This passive is just like their super attack effects, they're just loaded beyond belief. So strong combination of super attack effects, high amount of attack defense and start a turn. They are a orb changer to their specific type, that being STR for the first 4 turns, which is obviously nice. 80% damage reduction on the first turn, which is obviously very, very good. They, what else? They get 2 keeper keys for obtain, as well as 200% defense and guard as the first attacker in the turn. And if you're inside the second slot, you get 3 keeper keys for obtained, 200% attack, and 30% damage reduction as the second or third attacker in the turn. Let me tell you guys this for free. After that first turn, their most effective slot is going to be inside, I would say, actually, no. No, it's not. They could fit in either the first, second, or third slot. I'm lying. Never mind. Because that's granted, they just get those 2 supers off, and they build up their damage reduction up to 50%. That's just very easy. Yeah. Because first turn, you sit them inside the first slot, that's 80% damage reduction with guard. So, unkillable on the first turn. Second turn, they're going to already be built up on their damage reduction, that being up to 50% damage reduction. All they have to do is do 2 super attacks, which should be very easy for them to get because they have additional super attack chance granted your key is 18 or more. They get a guaranteed super if the key is at 24 with guaranteed crit. So this card can do up to 3 plus supers, so this should be very easy for you to get those supers off to get that damage reduction up, as well as that support for multiple turns. This card is very good. 5 key and 50% attack and defense for 2 turns with each super attack perform. I mean, come on now. Just 5 key and 50% attack and defense for the entire rotation for 2 turns. That's very, very strong. And then a 70% chance to dodge. Now, take this as the bigger picture. Let's say we're past the first turn, right? So inside the first slot, they'll have 50% damage reduction, guard, as well as a 70% chance to dodge. Granted, they activate their revival skill. Okay. And also, if they're inside the second or third slot, they're going to have, what's that? They're going to have up to 80% damage reduction, because they have already that 50% damage reduction for those two supers you do, as well as that 30% damage reduction for them just sitting inside the second or third slot. So that's 80% damage reduction and 200% attack, 3 keeper keys are obtained, crazy support, a 70% chance to dodge. This card's winning on both fronts. No, it doesn't even matter what slot you sit them in. I don't know why I was thinking that, because I completely forgot that they build up that damage reduction, bro. So ridiculously strong, easy, eh? Just strong, 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 no weakness. Absolutely not. And this is the truth's thumbnail. I think he was just using this as a little placeholder for their little card art. Just, you know, I get it. I get it. Okay, their, what's that? That's their revival skill. Okay, so 12 key. They get 50% attack for one turn, and they do a guaranteed crit, okay? And their 18 key, 100% attack for one turn, and raises superclass allies' attack by 80% for one turn. And their passive, Make a Miracle Happen, 500% attack at the start of turn, and 150% defense when HP is 30% or more. And all allies get 10 key and 100% attack and an 80% chance to crit, excluding this character. That's ridiculous offensive support. And they have a revival when this character or an ally in the same turn is KO'd, and they get additional 80% attack, and all attacks become guaranteed crits when finish effect is active. Holy hell. Could you imagine you get to the revival skill part of this card, and you built up all of this amount of attack? Just go into their Spirit Bomb. Their Spirit Bomb is doing generational damage. So, 500% attack, 150% defense, all allies get 10 key, 100% attack, and an 80% chance to crit. Just ridiculous offensive support. Don't forget that they also give 80% attack to the entire rotation post-super. So, all allies are, well, if you're a superclass ally, excuse me. Granted, you're a superclass ally, you're getting 10 key and 180% attack, and an 80% chance to crit when they're on rotation, of course, after their super attack, as well as their revival skill in their back pocket that just hits the boss with a fucking nuclear bomb. And the nuclear bomb that they're going to be unleashing on the boss is a guaranteed crit. And then we go over to this form. Just high amounts of damage reduction, guaranteed guard in the first slot, 3+ supers, 5 key and 50% attack and defense for multiple turns. So crazy support. They have literally every defensive ability to fall back on inside of their kit. Orb changing, high amounts of stats all over the place. Just great card. Great call all around. Well, high amounts of stats all over the place. 280% attack and defense right over here. 200% defense right over here, specifically inside the first slot. 200% attack right over here inside the second or third slot. Their support is counted towards them because it does say self-excluded. So that's the 5 key and 50% attack and defense right over here. But that's not really high amounts of attack and defense for themselves. That's really more so for the support. But even if then, that's going to help them out regardless. That's about it. We know why this card is strong. And then, of course, we have the EZA for these guys, who I'm not even going to go and get into that today. So I have to write down yesterday's and today's card inside my notepad because I just completely forgot to. I'm so sorry, guys. Look how many papers I have, bro. Like, bro, look at all this. I am lacking on these the live stream. But that's going to be about it. Holy hell. Say W EZA concept, just bust it. And add that to the fact that they are a 250% leader skill. So, that's going to be about it. I appreciate you guys watching. You guys are the best. I'll catch you guys next video. I absolutely love you all. Send me custom cards over to bhfcustomcards@gmail.com. So get to your custom card as soon as possible. I'm getting all these recent custom cards and EZA concepts out the way. I was going to read this, but guys, I am on strict, strict time constraints right now. So I have to skip this for the live stream in the future. So I'm sorry. I know I said that I'd read both of them if they don't look that, if the passives don't look that bit. And I could clear this out in this video, but I have to go. I have to record the next video, edit both of them, thumbnails, upload them, put it on Twitter, and do all that other stuff, so I have to get out of here. So that's going to be all. Leave a like, subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and yeah, peace.